Britain with a 5-goal margin going into this final period and looking set for a victory. The referee gets us underway for this second period. Away to my right in a moment, we'll see a change in the nets for Great Britain, wearing the light strip and playing from right to left, but leading by 7-2 and fairly comfortably. Peter Woods, the coach, has decided to give a few players a little bit more ice time, but now we're going to get the first penalty of the period for tripping, and referee Mr. Helwig from Krefeld is sending Merv Priest into the box, and we're going to have a power play the way of the Dutch. That is Stephen Foster, the Great Britain goaltender. He is in for the third period. Bill Morrison, it is, that has been in the nets for the first two periods, conceded just 2 goals and played well. But Peter Woods, of course, is giving experience to his other goaltender. How valuable, Bob, could this be when they come to the final countdown towards the Olympics?
Well, you need two strong goaltenders, don't you, just in case something happens in there. But Stephen Foster, he's a very, very capable youngster. He's got good skills. He's very quick in those nets. He's a reflex goalkeeper, and he seems to get that body in front of that puck every time somebody shoots at him.
Well, he could be tested very early on, because now Britain are facing the power play with Merv Priest sitting it out in the box. Stephen Foster could have his first save to make. Merv Priest in the box for tripping, the first penalty of the period. Remember, the Dutch have scored 2 power play goals already this evening. Could they get number 3 and get themselves back in the game? It's a long haul.
Well, specialty teams, they've been very successful, the Dutch, on these power plays. They seem to be able to get that puck in the zone, but the thing about it is it's good practice, and there's Mr. Mervyn Priest, 2 minutes for tripping. Swervin' Mervyn, that's what they call him.
Don't think he bought a razor over to Holland with him.
Oh, you'll probably keep that beard going right until they play the Swiss. A little bit of a superstition probably going there.
Power play then, the way of the Dutch at the moment. And there's 1:16 remaining on that power play. Power play generated by that penalty to Merv Priest of Basingstoke. Allowing Britain to fire the puck up the ice without the icing call, of course, because they're one short. The Dutch going to build from the back. 25 is Eric Landon. Defenseman coming up in support. That's Schaarsma with a shot he has from that blue line. And a chance there. And Foster sorely tested in just his second minute on the ice. And the goaltender coming up with the goods.
He lost that puck, Tony, but you see how quick he got himself back into it once he saw it. That's what I'm saying. He's got them quick reflexes.
This is vicious for Holland. Back here is Landman trying to create space. Von Ranzau failing to control the puck when it mattered. Still the Dutch hold it in. Great Britain leading 7-2. Just under half a minute remaining on the penalty for Merv Priest in the box. And eventually the referee, losing sight of the puck, deciding that a face-off should be held just adjacent to where that happened.
Jeff Lindsay, he's a steady defenseman, very defensive out there tonight for his side, but these barriers in this herringbone rink, they're a little bit older and they don't have the play that they have in them. And you can notice that a lot of the GB players trying to keep that puck out of trouble, they'll try and use the barriers. Of course, you're not getting the bounce, eh? And that puck isn't coming out of that zone, and it's causing a bit of problem for the GB side.
22 seconds remaining on the power play, the way of the Dutch. This is Huben. Marcel Huben, number 15. Trying to set his team going. But failure to control it by Abenal allows the British defence to clear their lines, and with the power play counting down, the goaltender losing patience with that. Back on the ice comes Merv Priest, and the British team are back to full strength. Shannon Hope, captain, bundled off it. Away they come, Cranston. This is Morgan to his left. Good work by 15 for the Dutch. That's Marcel Huben. Tough character, Mr. Huben. Already 1 penalty tonight. This is Cranston, number 4. Good work by Morgan. Trying to create space. And in front of the crease is Paddy Scott. Shot takes a deflection off the skates of the goaltender. I don't think he knew much about that. Now the icing call will take the puck back up to his end.
That's that physical presence kicking in for the Great Britain team. You can see them. They're buzzing around that zone all the time, but they're winning those loose one-on-one battles all the time.
Well, there's those penalty minutes so far. Holland, 16 minutes in penalties. That's 3 minor penalties and a 10-minute misconduct. And for Great Britain, well, there have been 7 minor penalties, totaling 14 minutes.
Pretty much even all the way around, but the thing about it is that 10-minute major penalty to the Dutch side, that's bumped their numbers up a little bit, hasn't it?
Well, certainly there, and he had to sit it out, the fellow of his team alongside him, to come on after 2 minutes. But now the Dutch with a chance here. That's good defensive work there by Rick Strachan for Great Britain. Puck again held up against the boards. Nobody seems keen on releasing that, but eventually it does come out. Now Britain comes away. 4-on-2 situation here as they storm forward. Doug McEwen trying to create space. The goaltender Lowes is equal to that as the shot goes in from Graham Garden. Ian Cooper holds it up against the boards. Garden gets possession again as the puck comes round this side, and the Dutch have a chance to clear. How much, Bob, will it be a damage limitation exercise by the Dutch now to keep the score respectable?
Well, they've got their pride to play for, you know, and they've got these youngsters, and, you know, one of the things is you like to give them experience, but you don't want to cause problems for them either. And if you get their hearts down a little bit, that's not a beneficial and a development sort of situation for this team.
Britain building from the back as the puck runs loose from an awayward pass by the Dutch. Good work by Kevin Conway, the scorer of the last and 7th British goal. It's Graham Waghorn playing it out. Over on this side, it's Merv Priest. Priest storming in goalwards, taken wide by Landman. Good defensive work by the Dutchman. Rich Little is number 9, winning it back for Britain. Landman again. This is his brother, Eric Landman. Jaco and Eric, the two, playing together. Good work there. This is Richard. There's going to be another penalty call here around behind the net. And I think it's the Dutch that are going to play shorthanded in just a moment. And it will be number 25, Eric Landman, I think, going to the box. The goalie's off away to my right. Paul Adey with the shot. But the puck came out of that defensive zone. And now the tripping call will take Eric Landman to the penalty box and give the Great British team, or Great Britain team, a power play.
Landman going into the box. Stephen Foster coming out of the net to get that extra attacker, so you can see that he's awake in the Great Britain nets. What I'm starting to see now, though, by the Great Britain side, this is a very big ice surface, and boy, are they really starting to take advantage of getting that puck into the zone and going wide, using those big corners to try and elude those defensemen. Lots of power there, by Rich Little in the offensive zone. They're just out muscling the Dutch side. Big, powerful forwards for Great Britain.
Chance here. This is Stephen Cooper, number 5. Chance to get forward. Puck cleared out of that defensive zone. How much will Britain use this period as practice? I mean, they've virtually got the game sewn up, Bob, now looking set for victory and looking forward to that Switzerland game.
But they're in a specialty team situation, and you always try and use these to your advantage. You know, game situations working very well in terms of practical opportunity. Watch them try and get the puck, set it up in the zone, just slow things down a little bit, gain control.
Playing it in space. This is 80, number 22. Back here, number 5, is Stephen Cooper. Far side, we got Dixon. Chance there with a shot for Morier. Steve Morier is the got that shot in. A brilliant shot by the man from Cardiff. Morier scoring his 2nd goal of the game and his 6th international goal for Great Britain to put them 8-2 in front.
If the power play is working properly, you break down that box, and there you see it. That little pass back and forth there. But there's Morey open because the box breaks down a little bit, and of course he gets that shot away. Now there's no other player on this ice that really has a better opportunity to shoot this puck than Steve Morey, and of course he's the guy that's given the trigger opportunity. What a goal.
Well, it was brilliantly set up by Paul Adey and Neil Morgan there, and Steve Morey now his 2nd goal of the match, and that ends the power play. Eric Langman's 2-minute penalty for tripping was costly, but now the Dutch are back to strength and have it all to do as Britain lead 8-2.
You can see these power play specialty team situations working very, very well for both sides. They're taking advantage of them in international competition. You got to try and stay out of that penalty box.
Mike Bishop sending Cranston away down the left. Britain now creating space, going for the wraparound. The goaltender Lois knocks it down there. Well, we can have a look at the power play goals this evening. Holland 2-on-4 power plays. Great Britain 1-on-1. So 100% record on the power play success for Great Britain. Holland's two goals both coming on power plays.
We talk about those statistics all the time in our domestic scene in the Super League, and any team that would have a 50% record on the power play, or for that matter 100% record, I mean, their coaching staff be very pleased with those results.
Just under 16 minutes remaining in the period. Matic slightly at fault on the 14 minutes there on the clock. My second humble pie of the day. The first one tasted better. David Longstaff, number 25. Good stick handling, creating an opportunity there for Tim Cranston. There's Paddy Scott, scorer of Britain's first goal. Buzzing like a demon. Longstaff, ready to provide a night on three occasions. The Clisier in front, slap shot from Admiral, knocked away by Stephen Foster. Foster so far with a clean sheet. Up fired into the corner, but from the wrong side of the red line. The icing call would take it back to Foster's defensive loan, and we can go down to ringside and join Nick Rothwell, our reporter, with Mike Blaisdell, the Britain's assistant coach.
Thanks, Tony. Success is something that we're trying to breed here in the Great Britain squad, and someone to help do that is Coach Mike Blaisdell. Mike, things are going pretty well for you tonight, eh?
Yeah, we're pleased so far. There's obviously some time left, but we've taken control of this game, and obviously we need to win this one to get to make the Swiss game all or nothing, and that's what we've intended to do, and it's working so far.
You guys are having a lot of odd man breaks, and you're not really making them count. Is that something you're going to work on for the Swiss game?
We've scored 8 goals, so I mean, we've got to be happy with the goal production. But we're missing a few chances, but we're creating a lot of chances, which we're very happy with. You only worry when you don't get chances.
Are you happy with the performance of the Dutch side?
Well, they've got a young squad. They obviously want to develop some of their younger players. They weren't out to win this game, I don't think, by any stretch of the imagination. But they've battled hard. I mean, they've worked very hard. But we got a little more experience than them, and we were playing pretty with a lot of confidence right now.
Thanks a lot, Mike.
Okay, thanks.
Well, the Dutch certainly showing their battling qualities. I'm sure their young players will be better off for the experience of tonight. They are 8-2 behind, but as they say, perhaps beaten and not disgraced.
That's right. They've worked very hard all night long. Thing about it is, they've never stopped trying so far in this game. Maybe perhaps a little more experience prevailing.
Britain knowing control here. McEwen creating the opening. The shot knocked away, and the goaltender Lowe is exceedingly busy. Now I think probably over 40 shots have got against the overworked goaltender, but now it's the Dutch on the break in the Tangerine Strip, and surely that was offside, but the referee, in fact, letting it go, and now Britain get possession. This is Doug McEwen, number 7. Richard Little fails to gather the pass as the Dutch dump it into the corner. This is Rick Strachan playing his man away. Kevin Conway is 29. Little is in front of him. So too is this man, Merv Priest. Good stick handling. Create the opportunity and the shot. And the goaltender at the second attempt knocks that away. Richard Little, a great chance for another one on the edge of the crease. This time, the goal comes adrift. They all dive in for it. The last touch, surely there was Merv Priest, and all but scoring a goal.
Oh boy, we got a goaltender. Looks like he maybe took an errant puck there. This is the Basingstoke Bison herd, and all three of them, Little, Conway, and Merv Priest. And I'll tell you, they're just all around that Dutch net. Always gaining battle, always winning it. But that puck's being kept deep, and it's really hard to defend when the puck is along the barriers in and around that area. That's just havoc for those defensemen.
Well, the injury there for Honore Loes in his 19th international match was caused by a wayward fist. I think the replay showed us there, but there's the Dutch goalkeeper. 45 shots have rained in on him. 8 goals have gone by him, but he's saved just over 4 out of 5. Well, with the goal coming adrift, the face-off taken just outside the Dutch defensive zone. Dutch side there, that's Chris Imers, of course, at the foreground. Plays in England for Kingston, or certainly did until this week.
Yeah, he's played well tonight. That's the thing about him. He's a big, strong, solid guy, and I'm sure that he'll find himself a job.
Coming away for the Dutch here, this is Van Lahoven, one of the debut-making players, but his pass was a bit wayward. And from the wrong side of the red line, which will take the face-off back down into his team's own defensive zone.
Dennis Tenbuckle, 17 years old. How about that, eh? You talk about circling the wagons. Two-line pass there, going the length of the ice. And we've got ourselves an icing call all the way back down.
They've got their puck. That's their triumph tonight. That's their prize that they go home with.
I like those knitted sweaters as well, Tony. You know, matching.
You need big, thick wool out here at the moment in Holland, Bob. Britain in possession. Number five there is Stephen Cooper. Comes across here. This is Merv Priest, 27. Fired into the corner. Lester Arts, it is, that breaks up the attack and comes away for the Dutch. Backhanded, dumped into the corner. Chase is on for Eric Langman. Chance there, comes back to 28, is John Versteeg. Now it's Britain that come away with Richard Little. Little has two men with him. This one is Lindsay getting forward. Fed by Stephen Cooper. Good combination from the two Manchester men. And there's the shot goes in. It's time from Kevin Conway. Missed by Stephen Cooper. This is Van Ranzau for the Dutch. As Britain change their entire lineup. Van Ranzau dumps it into the corner. Possession reverts to Shannon Hope, Great Britain captain. And now they mount it from the back. This is Paul Adey. Morey is in front of him. Good defensive work by the number 12 for the Dutch, Jeffrey Franken. This is Admiral bringing the puck away on this side. Lacks support as he dumps it into the corner. Stephen Foster knocks it down behind his goal. Has the feeling at the moment that Great Britain have a little bit in hand, Bob.
They do. You know, they're doing all the things technically right. And as Mike Blaisdell pointed out, I think a very important point, eh? You know, they're playing with a lot of confidence here this evening. And, you know, they've done the job. They've come with the task at hand, and they've been very credible at it.
And that man, Steve Morio, has played his part this evening with two goals. And that man, Peter Woods, will be quite pleased, I think, with this composed performance.
There's a guy put into a specific situation, Stephen Foster, and he's been very credible in and around that net there. You can see that he moves very, very good around the net. Good positional play by him, cutting down the short side of that net on that angle.
This is Paul Adey, number 22. Leaving the puck, Shannon Hope is captain. Hope sets Britain away. Moria with Neil Morgan, number 23. Seemed Adey went in a bit quick, but Morgan's stick work is good, and the keeper has to be alert to keep that out. Around behind the net, it's loose for Morgan to collect, and he's got a man back here, Shannon Hope. Good chance for Moria for his hat-trick. Knocked away there. Good work by Schausma, the defenseman. Puck held up against the boards yet again. Officials decide enough is enough. Both teams will change their personnel, and a face-off will take place just inside the Dutch defensive zone.
Stevie Moria, he's playing a physical game himself here tonight. You know, you see him digging a lot in those corners and everything else. Digging for the puck. I'd certainly say that's a bit of a contrast to his style, but it just goes to show you, you know, he's got the team at heart here, and they're all working together for a very strong common cause.
Well, that common cause is Olympic qualification for Great Britain, and this win here could take them on the way towards that. The shot going in from Graham Waghorn. Waghorn not had much ice time tonight, but certainly looking to profit by it when he's there. Bodies tumble. This is Imers for the Dutch, getting into out of his defensive zone. It's Mike Bishop, number three for Great Britain. Last year a teammate of Chris Imers at Humberside. This is David Longstaff with three assists tonight already. Good stick work. Unselfish play to Tim Cranston with a shot. And that goes high and wide and knocked down. The goaltender didn't know where that was as it dropped down behind him.
That's the thing about those big nets, eh, behind the goal there. You never know where that puck's going to bounce out. Goaltender has to be very much aware of that. Bit of a difference from playing with plexiglass, yeah?
I think he knows where it's going to bounce, but the nets can drop it anywhere and he can be caught unsighted. This is Cranston. Good work here for Longstaff. He deserves a goal, and the goaltender's equal to that. And eventually Britain claim the goal as it goes into the net. I think the referee could disallow that because he thought the goal came adrift. They're arguing about it. Britain believe they should have got it. The goal seemed to be adrift.
Hey, that's a goal.
Incredible.
You guys report
Have to wait. The referee in consultation with the goal judge.
David Longstaff, look at the moves this guy's got. I'll tell you, wowie, I'll tell you, that puck's on a string there. Is that puck in the net?
Well, they seem to think it was in the net. In fact, before the net came adrift, and the referee is going to the bench. He's given he's giving some instruction. He's ruled the goal out. He's been to the bench, given the official verdict. The British team have to smile, but are they two in front? I don't think they're too worried.
Well, that's right. The thing about it is the puck lying underneath the goalkeeper. You saw the goalkeeper behind the goal line, wasn't he? He's lying behind that goal line there, but of course no one knows where that puck is.
And we had our lawyer on our side there saying his piece, Tim Cranston. Dutch trying to break on the break. This is Lindsay, though, collecting the loose puck, but not before it's gone across that goal line. And the icing call will take it back down into the Dutch defensive zone. And with just over 7.5 minutes remaining, Britain 8-2 in front. And coasting. Well, those are certainly the Dutchmen in the crowd. We've got some British fans across to the far side from us. You see the Union Jack in the background there. And there they are. They're a happy bunch of fans.
Well, that's the official Great Britain Supporters Club, and they follow this side all the way around, all over the place, all through Europe. And as we said, you know, the players really do appreciate that, because that support is ever so vital, especially in close games.
Britain creating space. This is Lindsay down in front. Strachan with him. Strachan plays it up where it's well collected there, and a chance on the break here. That's Ian Cooper. McEwen's this side. Narrow angle shot knocked down by that very busy goaltender Loez for the Dutch. Puck once again held up as bodies pile in, but McEwen collects the loose puck. Graham Carden's getting out onto the edge of the crease, but it doesn't reach him. For Holland, can't clear the danger, and Lindsay piles it in, and this time Cooper can't collect that one. This is McEwen. Dutch coming away on the break. Britain dominating the game, though, still, and leading by 8-2. The icing call, though, now once again will take the puck back up to the defensive zone. Masterminded by the goaltender, Honore Loez, to our left. Well, there are the statistics, and Mr. Loez has just saved the 50th shot that's rained in on him during the game. 8 of them have gone in. He's had a very busy night.
Some very good quality shots as well on Mr. Loez there in the Dutch nets, and he's done a good job. But the thing about it is, you know, they're getting the opportunities, this Great Britain side, and they're certainly capitalizing, and I mean, that's a very good statistic.
Now the Dutch having an opportunity on the break. Lester Arts just went ahead too far. Good check on the boards, though, allows the British team to gather, and this is Richard Little. Priest is in front of him. Priest charges in. This is Little, number 9 on the puck. Brits creating space. There it goes from Dixon, the shot just off target from the blue line. Well, a marvellous evasion of a body check if ever I saw one from Del Cliseur. And the final shot there, a little bit off target.
I'll tell you, the guy that he snuck around there, Stephen Cooper, he's not the easiest guy to get around, but DeCluser, nice little move there. You know, you got to make sure that you look at the chest in those situations so those forwards don't get around you.
This is Steve Moria. Puck fired into the corner. Away comes the Dutch on the loose puck here. Good defensive work. Surely that man was offside because he went in ahead of the puck. Once again, Britain clears the danger. Neil Morgan working hard, number 23 for Britain. There goes the shot once again. That overworked goaltender Loez saves that well. Shannon Hope's shot goes in. The goal comes adrift away to my left. And now we can join Nick Rothwell, who this time is with some very happy and much-travelled British fans.
Thanks, Tony. Yeah, Great Britain not only have a great team, we got great supporters down here. Where did you travel from?
Medway.
And you?
Telford.
And we're all from Sheffield.
And you guys are enjoying the game?
Yeah, it's great. Not bad.
Now, I know I asked you earlier, you didn't think that was a goal, did you?
No, the net came off before it went in, definitely.
So, are you going to be at the game next week?
Yeah, yep, definitely. And the one on Sunday.
Can we listen how you're going to cheer?
Shannon Hope, spread my army, Shannon Hope!
Well, I wonder just where they got that chant from. Shannon Hope's red and white army, blue and white army. Didn't quite get it, Bob.
Followers all over the place, eh?
The Union Jack, whichever way you look at it. There's that overworked Dutch goaltender. 8-2 Great Britain lead with just over 5 minutes remaining. Well, we've got a penalty now on that goalminder who we saw there for removing the net. That, of course... Well, in Britain, we'd probably get that called as delaying the game, but the officials have given it for moving the goal. So 2 minutes it is, and a power play the way of Britain, who's got 1 out of 1 on power play success so far.
This is, again, Great Britain's opportunity to really capitalize and try and get this power play down, working at a full success tonight. Move that puck well and make sure that they get into that offensive zone and show a lot of confidence on the play.
Strachan to Morgan. Morgan is 23. This is Shannon Hope, number 6, working hard for his team. Great Britain on the power play. This is back with Rick Strachan, number 2. Chance for Shannon Hope with the shot. Goaltender equal to the deflection. The cover behind him from Schaafsma there, number 24, cleared the danger when the puck was loose and the goaltender didn't know where it was. Another shot. Canning off the pads there. Jaakko Landman clearing the puck up the ice where Steve Foster knocks it down. Just under 50 seconds remaining on the power play.
Great Britain getting that puck deep in his own now. This is where they need that guy in front of the net, the big solid guy there that can stand in there and pick up any loose change right around that goal mouth area, because there's all kinds of havoc happening around it and that puck's popping loose and in front of the net. That's where the guy's got to show some strength.
David Longstaff showing that strength at this time as they play the puck around. This is Cranston, shot from Paddy Scott. Eventually knocked away there for the Dutch by Versteeg. Only up as far as the neutral zone. 15 seconds remaining on the penalty. Power play the way of Great Britain. This is Lindsay. Longstaff, rather, taking the puck into the... round behind the net. He's got a man with him. It's Cranston. Cranston tries to score on the backhand. Goaltender spreads himself well. It's only cleared as far as Lindsay. The Dutch have survived the power play. The man sitting out the penalty there for them was Van Neer on behalf of his goaltender, Loes. He's now back on the ice. The Dutch are back to strength. And with 3 minutes remaining, Britain lead by 8-2. Good day's work for this lot, Bob.
They got to be pleased with their performance so far. There's a coaching staff there. Andy French, the manager of the team, he's running the gate. All systems go. Everybody's working well.
And Peter Woods, the coach, will be very pleased with this.
Well, it's all set up for that final stage in effort. It's that big game coming up against Switzerland. And I suppose this team's fortunes, they control their own destiny. It's in their own hands.
The 15 for the Dutch, bringing the puck away there is Marcel Huben. Chris Imers is number 20. Imers is looking for support. Stephen Cooper goes in with the check. Number 24 coming away. Dixon. McEwen is number 7. Passes astray. Dutch would like another consolation goal. They're in possession and they're coming out. This is Reeson. The puck goes out. Once again, with no plexiglass here, a little bit more time is wasted. And certainly there. A little bit of treatment on the Dutch bench.
Versteeg, he looks like he's took a whack there or whatever. You put the ice on it, try and keep the swelling down, you know, so he can stay in the game.
Well, sadly for the Dutch, a prize for effort, but this is their 7th game in these Olympic qualifiers, and it's 7 defeats. Chris Imers, though, has scored a goal for them this evening. Cooper leaves it for brother Ian. Is Doug McEwen, good stick handling again and created the opportunity and a chance there from Dixon as the puck was fired in, but now the Dutch come away again, opening out as we move into the last 2 minutes of the game. It's Chris Imers firing it into the corner. Both teams changing. Paul Dixon is 24 for Britain. Richard Little to his right, Stephen Cooper to his left. Merv Priest up here on the blue line. Priest can't control that. Abraal can. Chance for the Dutch if he can get the shot away here. He can't. Good cover by Stephen Cooper. Good work by the goaltender, Stephen Foster, behind him. There's Stephen Foster. It's a good period. Just one goal in. Not letting any goals in.
They're Great Britain. They're getting caught there. This is the thing about that forecheck by Holland. They give you a false sense of security, and of course that puck pops loose, and you kind of got all the guys going one way, and of course here comes Holland with a puck going the other.
A goal in each of the first two periods against Britain, both going past Bill Morrison, and he played his part, and now Stephen Foster has come in for the third period. Dutch not giving up. 22 is Jaco Landman. British fans making their presence felt. This is Sjalsma for the Dutch. Well, the puck coming loose there, and the goaltender once again courageous, diving down at the feet as the puck ran loose in that goal crease. Well, he can take a lot of credit from this game, Honoré Loez. It's 19th international match, and he's certainly been overworked, Bob.
He has, and he's done a good job, and it's so much as often the case, isn't it? You know, when you get a goalkeeper, his team very much the underdog. You know, he comes up very big for them. The more work they get, the better that they seem to play.
Just over a minute remaining on the match. Referee Helwig. Certainly had a good game for him. Goaltender once again subjected to barrage. This is 23, Neil Morgan. Morgan going for the shot. 80 looking for the puck dropping down. It didn't come his way. And the Dutch once again in the tangerine strip. In the neutral zone, regaining possession. This is Mike Bishop. Working well is Jeff Lindsay with him. Bishop shadowing von Ransau. Steve Morier is 19. As we move into the last half of the match, half a minute of the match. This is Paul Adey. Morgan to his left. Morier in front of him. Deflected shot. Knocked down by Morier. Tries to knock the rebound in as he palms it down to his stick. But now the Dutch coming away. Good skip there by de Clouzier because he survived that check, which could have been unpleasant.
Still a good play, eh? He didn't let the man go by. And the puck went. But you got to take one or the other.
Well, Britain in possession. The closing seconds. This is Stephen Cooper. The shot goes there. Another one saved by Honoré Loez. But a highly satisfactory performance by the Britain. Two power play goals counted for Holland from Chris Imers and Lester Arts. Britain led by 3-1 at the end of the first period. 7-2 at the end of the second period. Just one goal in the final period coming on the power play from Steve Morier, his second of the game.